As he sits in his Ottawa music studio, Thor Simonson still can't believe Kelly Fraser is gone.
It's an enormous loss.
Simonson produced Fraser's Juno-nominated album, Sedna, but he was more than a producer, he was her friend.
She was a beacon of hope for many. She gave voice to her people, many who couldn't speak. She spoke for them.
Simonson and Fraser did workshops in remote communities, teaching songwriting and music production skills to young people.
It was her life vision was to inspire other young Inuit to follow their dreams.
As news of Kelly Fraser's death spread, friends and fans were shocked and devastated. Senator Murray Sinclair described her as one of our young heroes with an important message for young Indigenous women and girls.
The loss of Kelly is a huge loss.
Rhonda Head is a Cree musician who met Fraser at the Banff Center for the Arts last month.
Her most inspiring message that I believe was singing in her own language, in her Inuk language.
Just last year, Fraser received an Inspire Award for using pop music to strengthen Inuit culture and language, and for sharing her personal struggles with substance abuse and her father's suicide.
Now I want to make music that young people will listen to because they're the ones that are in pain. They're the ones that need strength.
Fraser's cause of death hasn't been confirmed. She was working on a third album called Decolonize, which was set for release in 2020.
And I believe that this country and this whole world needs to hear my music so we can heal together.
Karen Pauls, CBC News, Winnipeg.